I'm back. This is part two of my two-part series on AI shortcuts that you need to know to save you hours, make faster decisions, and level up your productivity. And they have nothing, and I repeat, nothing to do with writing. And as promised, I have a revamped and refreshed AI guide complete with all 16 shortcuts plus more waiting for you at the end of this video. So keep watching. Hey Bossy, what's up? It's Alex, and this is part two of my two-part series on the AI shortcuts that you need to know right now to save you a ton of time and level up your productivity. We already covered eight in part one, and if you haven't seen part one yet, trust me, you do not want to miss it. I cover shortcuts from everything to help you, you know, creating complex Excel formulas, analyzing and replicating your top performing social posts, creating specific examples for your teaching frameworks and formulas, and so much more. You will find a link to part one in the description box below, and you can watch that next. No need to watch them in order. Now, let's kick off part two right where we left off, shall we? With shortcut number nine, evaluate tools and platforms. Okay, so honestly, how many times have you spent hours, weeks, months evaluating different softwares or tools or platforms trying to decide which one is best for you and your specific needs or the type of business you have? Whether it's, you know, an email tool or a CRM platform or payment processors, right? Using ChatGPT to help you filter and compare the options is an absolute game changer. So all you got to do is first describe what you're looking for. Like, can you recommend some different digital tools for mapping out marketing funnels visually? And then ChatGPT will give you a bunch of options. So in this case, it even divides them into simple, mid-level, and pro options, which is super helpful. I recommend you continue to work with ChatGPT to get a little bit more detailed and specific about what you're looking for. Like, which of these tools integrates with Airtable? Or I'd love to be able to incorporate conversion rates and have some analytical power with the funnel mapping tool as well. Which one would you recommend? You can even ask for pricing comparisons, which one is best for the number of people on your team, and literally anything else that you want to know, which will help you compare different options and make a faster decision. Next up is an absolute lifesaver for project managers, freelancers, or anyone who has to juggle a lot of different tasks. Shortcut number 10, break large projects into smaller tasks. So let's say you've got a large product or a series of deliverables and you're just feeling overwhelmed by the sheer scope of it all. I know it can be like a lot, right? And you want to break it down into smaller actionable steps or tasks for, you know, your project management software. Well, ChatGPT can do that too. You want to first describe your goal, and the more specific you are, the better. So think about what needs to get done and by when it needs to be done. Something like, I need to launch an online course in the next 3 months. It's going to include 5 modules, a website, a marketing campaign, and a customer support system. Can you help me break this project into weekly milestones with specific tasks for each week? I'm working with a small team of 3 people, a copywriter, a social media manager, and a VA. Yeah, pretty impressive, right? Here's ChatGPT's response. It will literally provide weekly or daily milestones with detailed steps. You can ask it to go even further by creating daily tasks for the first month and so on. And ChatGPT will even then give you more granular action items, or you could have it generate an Airtable template for you or an Asana task list. And once you break it down, make sure to save this in ChatGPT so you can return and refine it or adjust the timeline if unexpected delays happen. Now, next up is shortcut number 11, find relevant examples for inspiration. So this is a really great shortcut for finding inspiration for things like landing pages, lead magnets, and sales pages. As marketers, we tend to like want to see what other people are doing, right? And rather than, you know, aimlessly browsing the internet, hoping you stumble across something good that can provide that inspiration, you can ask ChatGPT what's working right now in your industry so that you can reverse engineer it for yourself. Not copy, you are simply looking for inspiration. So let's say you're looking for landing page inspiration. You can open a new chat in ChatGPT and just describe what you need. And remember, the more specific, the better. So who is it for? What's the offer? How are you using it? You could say, give me 5 examples of top performing landing pages for digital product launches, include a breakdown of why they work, messaging, layout, calls to action, and visuals. And then ChatGPT will give you landing page breakdowns about why they're effective to help you when writing your own copy or landing pages. Or if you've already written your landing page copy, you can ask ChatGPT to reformat it using the same structure as the example shared earlier in the chat. Just make sure you specify what example you want ChatGPT to replicate the structure of. You could use this prompt. I'm gonna paste in copy that I wrote for a landing page. Can you reformat this using the same page structure as the example you just shared? Now, you've got your own version optimized and tailored. Now, of course, all you have to do is actually read through it and make sure ChatGPT didn't like change your messaging or like add in incorrect information, because we know AI lies and this can happen. Moving on to shortcut number 12, set up or fix backend logic and automations. So setting up backend automations or fixing consumption and delivery logic in your online tools or membership platforms can feel like throwing spaghetti on a wall and hoping something sticks. And honestly, this one's a little over my head, but apparently my team does this all the time. With this shortcut, ChatGPT can help you make sense of it all. So we actually recently used this to fix logic inside one of our membership sites, which uses complex tagging and segmenting to ensure our members have access to the correct level of the membership at all times. So here's the prompt we used. We said there are 8 pages that I only want shown to members based on their tags below. And then we inserted the level pages and the corresponding tags and attributes. Help me create 8 segments and or logic to ensure only those with certain tags and attributes have access only to their corresponding pages above. Now, I know that's like a super specific example, but you can also use this to set up like an email funnel or onboarding sequence or other automated workflows where there's lots of logic and tags and segmenting involved. So for example, you could say something like, I'm building an onboarding email sequence for people who sign up for my free mini course. I want to send 4 emails over 10 days, track everyone who clicks the course link, and send a bonus if they complete all lessons. Can you map this automation out step by step, including triggers, conditions, and actions? So there's just like lots of rules and tagging, you know, involved. And ChatGPT will give you a step-by-step breakdown of that entire automation, including how to tag the user after each action and how the next action will be triggered. This will save you so much time when building out your new automations with more complex logic or exclusions, because sometimes that stuff just like makes your brain boil and you just need it like laid out clearly step by step. And here are some bonus prompts for even better results. Can you convert this into a Zapier logic flow with app to app automations? Or can you write 2 automation paths, one for beginners and one for more advanced users? That brings me to shortcut number 13, basic coding and bug detection. Yes, I am talking about fancy techie stuff like HTML and CSS and JavaScript. Basic coding skills are obviously very useful for people to have, but let's be honest, most of us do not. It is over our heads, and hiring a web developer or a coder to fix every teeny tiny little issue isn't really, you know, that realistic either. Luckily, ChatGPT can help you with some basic coding. So in a brand new chat, you're just simply gonna describe what you're looking to do or fix, and make sure to include context, like which platform you're using and what language, HTML, CSS, JavaScript, and so on, so that you can get, you know, the correct result. So for example, you could say, I want to create a button that scrolls to a section lower on the page when someone clicks it. I'm using basic HTML and CSS. Write the HTML and CSS for a button that says learn more and scrolls smoothly to the about section of the page. Not bad, right? ChatGPT will then give you something that looks like this. And I have no idea what that means, but you can just simply copy and paste it and voila, you now have the button you're looking for. And you can also use ChatGPT to help you debug your page. You simply want to copy and paste your error or your broken code, whatever's not working, into ChatGPT with this prompt. This code isn't working. Can you find the issue and fix it? And then of course it will, you know, tell you and detect what type of language it is, and then it'll fix it. Here are some bonus prompts that will get you even better results. Can you rewrite this to be mobile responsive? Or add a hover animation to this button code? Or turn this code into a reusable block that I can use on multiple pages? Or write code to embed a countdown timer on the page that ends Friday at midnight? I mean, I have no freaking idea how to do that. And here's another super useful shortcut. Number 14, flag email copy that could hurt deliverability. So you're writing emails and you want to make sure they land in the inbox and not the spam folder, or at least increase the odds that they land in the right place. ChatGPT can scan your email copy for any deliverability red flags and help rewrite risky phrases. So in a new chat, simply, paste the email copy that you wrote or the subject line that you're worried about. You're gonna say, I'm gonna feed you an email that I wrote. Can you analyze this email for phrases that could hurt deliverability or sound spammy? Give me rewrite options for anything you flag as spammy. Keep it natural and still persuasive. And then you got it. ChatGPT will identify any red flags and rewrite them for you. But you want to be really careful with this one, of course, because we know that ChatGPT can really overdo things when rewriting copy. And before you know it, your email doesn't sound like you at all because it has ripped all personality from it. So instead, you might just want to ask ChatGPT to maybe just rewrite a specific part of your email that is a red flag or something that might feel a little bit spammy. You could also say, what are 5 subject lines with high open rates that don't use spammy language? Or give me 10 different ways to say, click here to save 15% without sounding spammy or overly promotional. All right, now shortcut number 15, and this is one of my favorite ways to use ChatGPT, brainstorm acronyms, phrases, and catchy names. I mean, who doesn't love a good TLA, 3-letter acronym? I have to admit that coming up with acronyms and phrases and names is one of my all-time favorite things to do. I usually just get out like a pen and a notebook, and I just write down everything that comes to mind until I stumble across something that like really makes sense, right? Sometimes though, the juices just aren't flowing. Happens to the best of us. And that's when ChatGPT can be really, really helpful. So you're gonna open a new chat and you're simply gonna explain what you're naming or trying to create. Remember to be really clear about the topic, the tone, and the audience. So here's an example. I'm creating a 5-step framework to help creative freelancers land higher paying clients. I want a catchy acronym that feels empowering but not cheesy. Give me 10 acronym ideas where each letter represents a step in this process. Positioning, outreach, pricing, pitching, and closing. Make the tone confident, modern, and slightly edgy. And then what do you know? ChatGPT will actually give you some pretty good options. Then of course you can work on refining it or maybe combining different ideas. I wouldn't copy it like fully because then other people might be copying it too. But then of course, once you've got your acronym or your name or your phrase, you can add even more prompts. For example, make it sound more fun and aspirational, or add in a little bit of sass and playfulness if that suits your brand voice. Or what's a memorable name for a digital product bundle for coaches? Or give me 10 tagline ideas that convey fast results and expert support. Or write a catchy phrase that I can use to describe this bonus to make it feel irresistible. Or give me 10 words that start with a P and relate to leadership, which is really useful if you're coming up with an acronym, but there's just like one letter that won't fit, right? And you're like, I need it to be a P. And then last but not least, shortcut number 16, brainstorm irresistible and complimentary bonuses. So one of the biggest rules in great sales and marketing is to have an irresistible offer. And as you know, adding in bonuses is a really great way to increase the perceived value of an offer, making it more irresistible. The only problem is sometimes it's hard coming up with the right bonuses, right? We feel like we're just kind of throwing a bunch of stuff into the pan and been like, oh, I hope people think that's valuable. Well, ChatGPT can help you come up with relevant and valuable bonuses that directly support your main product. So you're not just giving a random bonus, but something that actually helps people get more results with the core offer, product, or service. So you're going to open ChatGPT and you're simply going to describe what your offer is, make sure to say who it's for, the problem it solves, and of course the delivery method. So is it live? Is it a course? What is it? You could say, I'm launching a $497 course that teaches designers how to find premium clients on LinkedIn. I need bonus ideas that increase perceived value and help buyers implement faster. Give me 5 strategic bonus ideas for a LinkedIn client attraction course for freelance designers. Bonuses should be easy to deliver, perceived as high value, and help people get results faster. Pretty simple, right? ChatGPT will then come up with a bunch of ideas. Pretty cool, right? And here are some additional prompts for even better results. You could say, make the bonuses sound more premium, or which of these bonuses should be fast action versus evergreen and just available with the offer all the time. Or give me bonus ideas themed around saving time because I really want to help my people save time. Or write descriptions for each bonus so they sound irresistible on the sales page. And then of course, you can also use ChatGPT to reverse engineer a bonus you already have. Like, hey, here's a bonus that I already have. Can you tell me if it actually supports the main offer? And if so, how can I communicate that or how can I improve it? And that's that. You officially have everything you need to make ChatGPT your productivity secret weapon. Whether you're building funnels, brainstorming offers, or planning your next big launch. Let me know in the comments below which of these 16 shortcuts you are going to try first. And if you're a freelancer, a copywriter, or a business owner, and you really like these behind the scenes videos, please let me know. Give me a thumbs up below and subscribe to my channel below so you don't miss any more videos like this one. And don't forget to check out part one if you haven't watched that yet. You can find a link to that below. And as promised, I also have a fully refreshed and updated AI guide for you with all 16 AI shortcuts, plus so many more that I didn't even talk about in this video. You can grab your copy in the description box below, and I will see you next week with a brand new video. Until then, I'm Alex. Ciao for now. All right, guys, if you enjoyed that video, make sure to check out the next one from me right here. And you can click right here to get a free gift.
If you are only using ChatGPT to write content or get answers to random questions, you're doing it wrong. This is part one of my two-part series on genius AI shortcuts that you need to know to save you hours, make faster decisions, and totally level up your productivity. From data analysis to back-end automation and more, I've got tons of practical and actually useful ChatGPT prompts that you can start using today. And honestly, number 7 could save you hours alone. So keep watching.